Welcome to the Quantemol database basic tutorial. In this video I'll be showing you around the database and showing you how to search for species and reactions and where to find chemistries. So let's get started. When you first log into the database you'll be brought to this home screen. In the centre of the screen is a search box. Now this will allow you to start searching for species straight away. On the right hand side of your screen is a news feed. So as soon as there are new developments with regards to QDB, so this could be papers which have been released or new chemistries which have been validated, that will pop up in your news feed. On the bottom left hand side of your screen is the current status. So at the time of recording this video, 5,173 reaction datasets are available on the database. So let's go ahead and start searching for species. Now you could do this using the search box on the homepage, or if you go to the species tab, there's a drop down menu, which you can click on search and you'll be brought to this page here. So let's use argon as an example. And what will show up is a table which contains information on argon in its different states. You've got argon in its excited states, and you can have a little scroll down, have a look. There's also information on the number of processes which involve argon as a reactant or as a product. So let's click on one of these argons as an example. Now, as you can see, you've automatically been shifted from the species tab to the reactions tab. Now you could start by searching for a reaction. So if you go to the reactions tab straight away from the homepage, click on search and you can begin your search there. You've also got the option of selecting whether you want to see your species in a reaction as either a reactant or a product. So you can click on either or. In our example, we've clicked on both reactant and product. So you'll be provided with a table which has a list of the reactions which argon is involved with, and you've got information on how that data is available. So whether it's available as cross-section data, as rate constant data, or in some cases both. So it will have a tick next to the type of data that's available. Now let's have a look at some rate constant data. So this reaction over here has a tick beside rate constant data, so if we select this reaction, this will take us to the data set. Now over here, D2055 is the data set ID, and I'll come back to this in just a second. Now this is available as Arrhenius parameter sets, and we've got the parameter values reference, so where this has come from. There's also a link to the article, so if you click on this, this will take you straight to the article, and a user rating. Now, you can access the data sheet by clicking over here, or you could click on the dataset ID, and that will also take you to the data sheet. Now, the data sheet allows you to report any issues that you might have with the data. And you can also rate the data. So this rating is given by fellow users, so you can give it a rating, and you can also leave a comment saying, yes, I've used this data, maybe what you've used it for, and your thoughts. So that's rate constant data. Let's go back and have a look at some cross-section data. So this reaction over here has a tick beside cross-section, so we can click on the reaction, and this will take us to the data set. Now for this particular reaction, you can see there are two data set IDs. Now the reason for this is because for the same reaction, there's information on cross-sections from two different sources. So if you scroll down, you've got data set D3, so you've got information on the reference and where that's come from, and if you scroll further down, you've got dataset D4888 and information on where that has come from. So let's scroll back up and have a look at the graph, which is available either in linear format or logarithmic. If you want to zoom into this graph, you can draw a box and this will allow you to zoom in. can also press this button over here to reset that. And you can also download this cross-section data for both these data sets. If you just hover over the question marks, this will let you know which format you should be downloading this in. Now, for both of these data sets, you can click on the data set ID, or again, you can click on data sheet over here, and this will take you to the data sheet for that data set, where you can again rate this data and leave a comment. Right, so let's just go back to the reactions list. Just to make a quick point here, when you compare cross sections, you can compare up to 8 data sets. But as we've just seen, it's worth keeping in mind that a reaction might have several data sets associated with it from different sources. So let's just say that you're comparing cross sections for different excitations in argon, and how you can select different reactions and compare them. So let's have a look, and we've got this icon next to the reactions which have data available as cross-section data. So if you click on this green icon, you can see on the box on the left, it just pops up over here, showing you that you've selected this reaction. If you click on the red X, that will take it out of the box. Let's click on it again, and that will reappear. Let's select a second reaction to compare it with, and that pops up in the box. And if you just click on the compare button here, this will provide you with the data sets and the graph comparing both cross sections. So you've got the data set IDs, you've got the graph available as either linear or logarithmic. You can zoom in on the graph, and again you can click on the dataset ID, and that will take you to the data sheet where you can rate the data and leave a comment. And you can download this information. Again, if you just hover over the question mark, that will give you information on what format you should be downloading this as. It's also worth mentioning at this stage that if you're a subscriber and you have plasma modelling software, you can enable an API and access the data from QDB within your plasma modelling software interface. So I will make a separate video about this, but if you have any specific questions, I'll show you how to get in touch with us later on in the video, and feel free to ask us any questions that you have. Right, so let's have a look at chemistries now. So if we go to the chemistries tab on the drop down menu, select all chemistries, that will bring us to this page here. Now this section is available for gold QDB users. So if you want to find out a little bit more about gold membership, I'll show you towards the end of the video how to get in touch with us. If you've got any specific questions, please feel free to ask. So if we scroll down this page, we can see a list of the chemistries available, and beside those chemistries is a star rating. Now just above that list is a table which explains the star rating. So if a chemistry has been given a 5-star rating, the reason behind that is the chemistry is self-consistent and validated by comparison of results using more than one software model. So let's go ahead and click on one of these chemistries. What you'll be provided with is process conditions, surface reactions, and validation details. If we scroll up, there are tabs, and if we click on reaction list, this will show us the reactions which are taking place in that chemistry. And if we click on one of these, this will shift us back to the reaction tab, and we're provided with information on the data set. So again, you can download this information in different formats, you can rate this data set, and you can view the graph in different formats. So let's go back. You can download this information again on the chemistry, you can leave comment on the chemistry, You can go back to the notes section. Again, it's worth keeping in mind over here, if you do have a plasma modeling software, you could link QDB with your software using an API, and this will save you a lot of time. So if you've got any questions on that, again, get in touch with us, but I will make a separate video on this. Fantastic! So we've gone through how to search for species, how to search for reactions, and where to find chemistries. Now, if you've got any specific questions for us, please do get in touch. If you click on the contact tab over here, there's a contact form so you can fill in some information and leave us a message, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. We've also got an email just on the bottom of the website, so sales@quantemol.com. So you can email us on this email and we'd be delighted to hear from you. Now, on the About Us tab, there's a bit more information about the team, the advisory board. There's also a brochure. If you just click on this, click on the brochure, that will give you a bit more information about QDB itself. So if you found this video useful, give us a thumbs up and leave a comment letting us know what you'd like to see next. And in the meantime, happy plasma modelling!